So one of the big, one of the great important things about sensing is that sensing is an enabler, a facilitator of many of the macro trends that we're seeing today. And we are we're not the only sensing business within Honeywell, but we are the largest, most comprehensive sensing portfolio. One of the most important macro trends that we know is important to Honeywell across the business, and important, frankly, to all businesses and all markets, is sustainability. And within that, electrification and this kind of energy transition that we're seeing as we move to more hydrogen or other forms of clean energy economies, the use of sensing within that space to detect, to keep people safe, to be able to help the rollout of more advanced technologies is absolutely critical. And one of the best examples, the most relatable examples, is within the electric vehicle space. Particularly the lithium ion, but not exclusively the lithium ion electric vehicle space.
Yeah, so speaking of electrification and EVs, we know they're becoming more popular and, you know, more drivers are planning to switch to EVs in the near future. What are some of the biggest challenges to overcome as we accelerate adoption around EV?
There's a number, and just to give some kind of relative size to what we think is going to happen, by 2030, it's projected there'll be more than 26 million electric vehicles on the roads in the US alone. We know there's legislation in other regions worldwide, like Europe, which will effectively prevent the sale of combustion engine vehicles after 2030. And by then, it's estimated that more than 60% of all the vehicles sold will have some form of electrification as a means of power. But it's not a simple evolution. It's not a simple path to having all of this scale in electric vehicles. There's two or three particular areas that need to be focused on, or problems to resolve. And that is the infrastructure. So the charging infrastructure for primarily the primary method of creating electric vehicles with lithium ion batteries, and they'll need to be recharged. So the charging infrastructure is very, very important. And you know, depending on the country or the region or cities versus rural areas, there's relative differences in the availability. So that needs to roll out. The availability of lithium is obviously a core need. And then one of the biggest areas to address is safety. Now, obviously, electric vehicles are inherently safe. We wouldn't drive them if they weren't. However, there are issues around lithium-ion batteries, thankfully very rare, but they do happen, where there are situations where we have something called thermal runaway, and that is where the battery itself begins to self-heat to an uncontrollable level. That can ignite and cause fire, and obviously a burning lithium-ion battery is quite a catastrophic event because it's very, very difficult to extinguish. So the safety of batteries in the vehicle, and obviously for the asset, but also the occupants of that vehicle, is being able to really maintain that safety is incredibly important going forward.
Yeah, I completely agree. And we hear a bit about that, you know, lately. How do our sensors for EV batteries work exactly? How are they part of that solution?
So we have two or three different offerings at the moment. We have, and all of them relate to how the battery effectively degrades. So the thermal runaway is one option. So it self-heats. And that when that battery heats, it releases gases. It releases materials, and ultimately it can burst into flames. But also there are also factors where other different materials within the battery will degrade. So such as the metal oxide cathode, which will release oxygen. There are electrolytes in the battery which will ignite the oxygen, resulting in the similar situation. It results in flame and catastrophic failure. So we have developed a number of sensors. One of which is an aerosol sensor, which uses light. Our optical technology I mentioned at the start that uses light to detect the aerosols, and we have a battery pressure sensor which detects the change in pressure within the battery unit, and that will also determine that there is a failure. And we have new technology developed with our partner Nexeris, which actually is able to detect off-gassing very, very early in the thermal runaway process. So much earlier than you would normally be able to detect gas or debris or any other means of detecting flame. And that's really important because the earlier you detect a potential battery failure, the earlier that notification can be, in the vehicle, to the occupants, etc., to obviously allow the occupants to exit safely, but also potentially to protect the asset. And as we further develop this over time, it won't just be a monitoring device. It will ultimately, as sensing becomes more digitized, more intelligent, be able to not to predict and then ultimately prevent a more catastrophic failure. So that is the goal. It's a real revolution in our roadmap to be able to really drive on vehicle in battery safety using sensing technology that's core to SST.
Wow, yeah, so that's very clear where the role of sensing is so critical to this transition.